bounced off the walls on my way down, catching a few vines and roots, slowing my fall just before I hit the ground, probably saving my life. Glove landed on my chest, knocking the air from me for a moment. I was just thankful that the two of us had survived. We got up, taking in our surroundings. We had landed somewhere in the mouth of a large cavern. Sunlight shined in from the holes in the cavern's roof, illuminating a field under the dome of the stone ceiling. Brushing myself off, I stepped out into the field. By the looks of it, we had accidentally discovered some sort of underground road. What caught my attention more than anything, though, was a pyramid made from a gold-toned stone that rested right in the middle of the field. Still wary from the fall, dealing with the cult, Glove and I began to make our way toward the pyramid. Still, the events that happened back up in the church clutched at my mind. For a city like that to have been taken over so quickly by a cult worried me. And that symbol Nilan had cut into the woman, it felt like I remembered it from somewhere, in a book or something. When we got out, I knew I'd have to ask around and do some more research. Glove led the way, guiding us to the base of the pyramid, where a tall stone archway held its doors open for us to enter. As I looked closer at the stone, I noticed that the same symbols we had seen earlier had been carved into the archway. Cautiously, Glove and I entered. We found the pyramid to be littered with traps and puzzles, to which we nearly escaped. In the end, Glove and I found ourselves in front of a tall wooden door. We assumed this to be the center of the pyramid. I took a deep breath, placing my hands in the door before pushing it open.